Hi boys and girls, tonight's lesson is lesson 59, which is subtracting a fraction from 1. Before we get started, we're going to look at these three different fractions. Now, what can you tell is similar between all three of the fractions? If you said that they are all equal to 1, then you are correct. With any fraction, if the numerator and the denominator are exactly the same, then that fraction is always going to be equal to 1. If you look at 3/3, you see that the denominator tells us that it is out of 3 pieces, and the numerator tells us how many pieces we have. So, in this circle, it's divided into 3 pieces, and our numerator tells us we have all 3, then we have 1 whole. Same if we come over to this one. It is out of 2. Our denominator tells us how many pieces it is out of. And then our numerator is going to tell us how many pieces we have. And if we have 2, then we have 1 whole. We have a whole of that circle. And same with 5/5. It's out of 5 pieces, and our numerator tells us we have all 5, which is also equal to 1 whole. Go ahead and pause the video if you want to write down the next few examples. You may try them by yourself, or you can wait and do them together with us. All right, write a fraction equal to 1 that has a denominator of 4. Well, we know that the denominator is the bottom half of the fraction, so I'm going to go ahead and write a 4 in there. Now, what does my numerator have to be if I want this fraction to equal 1? Well, our bottom number tells us that if we had a square or some type of circle, that it would be out of 4 pieces. And if we want it to equal 1 whole, then our top number has to be 4 as well, because we have all 4 of the 4 pieces. All right, now on to our next example. Again, you can pause it and write down the problem and try it yourself, or you can do it and follow along with me. Bailey and her friends cooked 2 identical pizzas. Bailey ate 1/4 of one pizza and 3/4 of the other pizza. What amount of pizza was eaten? Now, there are a few ways to do this. The first way that we're going to do it is draw some circles. So if we have 2 pizzas, I'm going to draw 2 circles. And the problem tells us that they are out of 4. So I'm going to go ahead and cut my circle into 4/4. Now, if I go back to the problem, it said that Bailey ate 1/4 of one pizza. So I'm going to call this pizza number 1, this pizza number 2. So Bailey ate 1/4. So I'm just going to color in one of those pieces. Now, the next part of the question says that Bailey ate 3/4 of the other pizza. So I'm going to go ahead and shade in 1, 2, 3. Now, if I were to count all these pieces that were eaten, I would say I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have 4 pieces out of, my denominator is going to be 4, because these pizzas are out of 4 pieces, and we have eaten 4 of those pieces. So my answer would be 4/4. Well, what do you know about a fraction when the numerator and the denominator are exactly the same? We would say that that is equal to 1 whole. Now, the other way that you can do it is take 1/4 plus 3/4, and then you add the numerators. 3 plus 1 is 4. You do not add the denominators because they are out of the same number. 4/4. And if I have 4/4, I know that that is also equal to 1 whole. So what amount of pizza was eaten? 1 whole pizza. All right, on to the next example. It says compare these 2 numbers. So I have 4 3/3 and 5. Well, what do I know about 3/3? If my numerator and my denominator are exactly the same, what do I know? I know that this is really 1. So if I take my 4 whole plus my other one that is a whole really looks like this, 4 plus 1. So if I compare these two numbers, 5 and 5, I would say that they are equal. All right, we have 2 other long problems. If you want to pause the video to write them down and try them by yourself, you can. Okay, first one. Mason spent 1.5 hours cleaning, and his sister, Alyssa, spent 1.5 hours doing yard work. How many hours did they work all together? And when I see that word all together, I know that they are going to be adding. So we're adding this 1.5 hours to this other 1.5 hours. So I'm going to write down my problem. 1.5 plus 1.5. When I do this, I am going to add the whole numbers together first. So 1 plus 1 is a big 2 because it is my whole number. And then I'm going to add my 2 fractions together. My denominator is going to stay the same. And if you remember, we can only add or subtract fractions when the denominator is the same. So now we can go ahead and add these 2 fractions together. 1 plus 1 is 2. But when we look at this answer, we know that this number, 2 and 2 halves, this number, 2 halves, can be changed into a 1 whole. So my answer is really 3, and my unit is hours. 3 hours. Alright, and this is the last and final example before your lesson practice. Javon baked a pie. His family ate 1/3 of the pie for dessert. What fraction of the pie was not eaten? This one's a little tricky. So, if I have 1 whole pie, I'm gonna draw a circle for this, and I divide it into 3 equal pieces, okay? His family only ate 1/3 of it. So we wanna know what fraction of the pie was not eaten. Now, you could look at your picture and say, okay, well, if that's each piece is 1/3, so 1/3, 1/3, and 1/3, I can just add that really fast, and that I know that equals 2/3. And you would be right. But what we want to try now is to take and write a problem for this. So I'm going to say 1 whole pie minus the part that was eaten, which is 1/3. Now, we don't really know how to do this problem, do we? There's a 1, and I don't know how to subtract a fraction from a whole number. What we have to do is turn this whole number into a fraction too. And if we remember again, we can only add or subtract fractions when my denominator, my bottom number, is the same. So what should I change this 1 into to make this problem work? What number is equal to 1 that also has a denominator of 3? If you said 3/3, then you are correct. So I'm going to take 3/3 minus 1/3. When I do that, I remember the denominators stay the same. 3 minus 1 is 2. So again, we can check our answers. We both get 2/3. Now, the rest is your lesson practice. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 problems to do. These problems will be checked when you come into school tomorrow. So go ahead and pause your video and you can copy them down.